Hello everybody, and welcome back to XCOM Long War. Last time, I mistakenly called this place a gas station, but as it turns out, it was actually a bank. And with a bomb set to explode at the strategically placed financial center in Canada, we've already used up too much time for this introduction. I'm your host Nitesco, now let's get started. We touch down surrounded by partial cover vehicles which, much like the bomb, are prone to exploding. Now, our current goal is threefold. Find the main bomb as quickly as possible, disable the nodes as we go, and try not to die recklessly. The main bomb is likely on the opposite corner of the map, so we'll send our troops around the left side for the superior cover and the nicely distributed bomb nodes. Each time we disable a node, it will add one turn to the clock. We start by checking our motion tracker, and with the pod to the north, we immediately move to contact. We brought a lot of shotguns and explosives in order to eliminate threats quickly, but just now, our infantry's mid-range support is what we'll need. Alieva lines up a flank and manages to make quick work of one of the sectoids. With one down, we move everybody else up and set up our overwatch to pin the aliens in place. This sectoid feels particularly bold, however, and decides that a trash can is better cover than a semi-truck. But our troops' laughter is quickly cut short when a lone thin man scurries off into the shadows. We move our assault Ortega up to try and kill the remaining sectoid, but he comes up one damage short. Our engineer Brown focuses her attention on the potentially lethal thin man and tries to destroy his cover. While we do get eyes on, he's one wall too far and still in full cover. But we came prepared with an unreasonable amount of explosives, and so a rocket manages to expose him. We move our infantry Alieva out of her flank position and line up a shot, but to no avail. So we run and gun our second assault Dostoevsky up against a wall to finish the job. With one sectoid left, we use our gunner Richard to suppress. The little guy probably regrets taking the trash can as cover, but it's too late now, so he hunkers down. It's too early to celebrate, however, because we have another pot of sectoids that just activated out of our reach. Back on our turn, we start by cleaning up the remnants of the first pod so that we can fully focus on the issue at hand. We bring down one node, and then another in our quest to get line of sight on this new pod of sectoids. It appears they're hiding along the northern wall of the bank, and Alieva might be able to get a nice juicy flank, but she checks her motion tracker just to ensure that we're not going to activate any more pods. It appears that there may be one more pod, so we settle for a couple of overwatches instead. We pull back our soldiers on point and let the sectoids fall into our trap. One overwatch hits, but doesn't kill, so the sectoid lines up to fire at our infantry, activating our covering fire feat for the first time. Unfortunately, this feat doesn't make its best first impression, and the shot misses. Meanwhile, the other pod our motion tracker detected rolls up, and a purple-headed sectoid rears its ugly face and goes into overwatch. On the bright side, we have every action accounted for this turn. On our turn, Roseanne gets a rocket shot that's too good to ignore. With four possible hits, even if it veers left or right, it's still likely to earn at least two. Apparently, one sectoid is behind an indestructible wall, and a rocket only earns one kill. We have two possible flanks, but first, our gunner removes the overwatch with a suppression, and our infantry backs up to reload. Finishing off our turn, we move our soldiers into position and discover the main bomb. One after the other, our engineer Brown takes several mine flays to the face, but somehow comes out unscathed. And back on our turn, we see one of the sectoids has went into overwatch. We destroy the previously indestructible wall with an HE grenade, but we can't get a good shot on the overwatching sectoid. Instead, Ortega throws a curveball and lands a flashbang at its feet, and Dostoevsky runs and guns and finishes it off. With a fresh magazine in her rifle, our infantry Alieva moves towards the right side to disarm another node. One overwatch and a reload later, our turn is done. With only two of the original five left, we get one overwatch and a broken window. Careful of the glass, guys. Alieva takes her first shot, but after it misses, she uses her second move to go into overwatch. This round, we focus on improving our position, so we run two soldiers up towards the bomb, suppress a sectoid, and put two into overwatch before ending the turn. One of the sectoids takes an action, and once again, covering fire fails to deliver, though I swear, it will get good. The sectoid manages to suppress Dostoevsky, and the second takes a missed shot. On our turn, we start by moving Alieva closer, but she's unable to get a line of sight, so she uses the chance to reload. Dostoevsky disables the bomb. In hindsight, we were doing pretty well and probably should have used those remaining turns on the clock to clean up the last two sectoids before disabling it, because next turn, a wave of thin men will be airdropping in. But it's too late now. So we set a few overwatches, a suppression, and brace ourselves for the storm. Count them with me, folks. There is one, two, and three. Unfortunately, none of these paratroopers trigger an overwatch. One is out of range of a flashbang, and half my squad is stuck in place fully exposed. Sometimes, you have to roll a hard six, and so I trigger the overwatch with a dash to full cover. It thankfully misses, and I'm free to move. So, we move our guys into cover in preparation for the next turn. These sectoids need to die sooner rather than later. My troops are flanked by an overwatching thin man, and it's time to gamble with their lives once again. If my plan works, I'll be lucky. If it doesn't, I'll have two dead soldiers. Hasta la vista. The plan was a success, and the thin man is dead. Unfortunately, the sectoids still live, but baby steps, our situation is slowly improving. Pause. Does anyone see what I just did? I'll give you a hint. That's right, I've completely forgotten about the third thin man. She manages to land her reaction shot, finishing off one of the sectoids, while the other remains flanked and has to reload. I look to clean up what I think are the last remaining sectoid and thin man, but my soldiers are wildly unsuccessful. On the alien turn, the sectoid is finally hit by covering fire, but with 1 HP remaining, it manages to wound our assault. At least the thin man misses though, so, silver lining. Our engineer ends the thin man, and we flashbang the sectoid. However, it turns out to have been a waste as we managed to kill it anyways. But when this turn doesn't end, I begin to panic. Let this be a lesson to all. Always count your enemies, and always know their location, especially with paratroop thin men. The bastard is flanked, and our troops and myself are eager for blood. Brown finishes off the thin man, and the mission with him. While the mission is a success on paper, in my mind, it's a horrific failure. This wasn't like losing a rookie. Olieva was with us since our very first mission, and was one of our highest promoted soldiers. This serves as a huge setback, and will hit us very hard in the coming missions. KIA. As a commander, those are the three letters I dread seeing most. Our two assaults were also wounded, and will be in the medbay for about a week. Our pickings from this mission are slim, with a few corpses and some weapon fragments, plus the $200. Definitely not worth our lost soldier. But it's time for today's only promotion. Our very first corporal, Fiona Brutal Brown. Ranger would improve Brown's firearms damage while Smoke and Mares would allow her extra support grenades. But Brown is a sapper engineer, a brutal goddess of death and destruction. And every feat we take is to further those ends. So, with that in mind, we pick up Heat Warheads. This will allow her grenades an additional 50% damage against robotic enemies. This is invaluable given robotic enemies' damage reduction. We set to work on the final portion of our lift, and upon scanning, we almost immediately are given a new abduction. It's a moderate mission, and we're short on promoted soldiers, so we send our remaining Lance Corporal, two specialists, and a gaggle of rookies. Our sniper Peters will provide ranged support while our infantry Steinman takes point with our motion tracker. Vasseur will give us suppression capabilities, and the rookies are supplied with a flashbang and smoke grenade each. This mission will rely on old-fashioned outmaneuvering on our part. It appears the aliens have targeted a popular tourist shopping center down in Leon, Mexico. Join me next time as XCOM interrupts these sectoid sightseeing in Operation Black Flame. As always, thank you for watching. Commander out.